Hi guys and welcome to the next episode of the Keto To-Do List series on my channel. And in this tutorial we will finish the database operations with MySQL database. And for that we will straight jump into the code and go to the database manager and implement some more methods. We will start with method that returns a single database to-do entity. And we do that by creating a method getTo-Do with an ID parameter. And the return type will be a DBToDo entity that can possibly be null if you specify the wrong ID. And now we return KDOM database a sequence of DB to do tables. So always when we select something from a table with KTOM, we start with KTOM database sequence of and specify the table name here. So the object that points to the table and contains all tabled information. And then we say first or null, where it ID is equals to ID. Let's put a line break here. And the cool thing about KTORM is that it is really similar to the normal Kotlin collection method. So find or first, everything is here. And what it does in background, so we can go to the implementation, see that it filters for the predicate and gets the element at zero or null. And that filter here applies a where condition. So it is not the case that the sequence of returns the complete list. So for example, thousands of entries if the table is full and then filters it, but instead applies this predicate and adds it to the SQL statement. So what the code does is creates a statement select all from to-dos where ID is equal to that ID parameter. And that's really cool because it is very performant and you can make use of database indices. Okay, the next operation that we implement is the add to-do operation where we pass in a to-do draft and return a database to-do entity. And now we make use of the KTOM database insert and generate key method. And in that method, as a first argument, we first have to specify the table where we want to insert something. So that's again DB to-do table. And then in the lambda block, we call set methods for each column we want to set. So we want to set the table, the title from database to-do table dot title to draft.title. And we want to set the done value to the done value from the draft object. We don't have to set the ID here because that ID is generated automatically. That is only possible because we called insert and generate key. If we only call insert, then no ID is generated for us and an exception will be the result. So let's call method insert and generate key and the response will be the inserted ID. Unfortunately, this is of type any, so our inserted or our ID column is from type int, so we can cast that to an integer and then yeah, we have inserted ID in integer form. And now we can simply return a new to-do object, not a draft, a to-do object with the inserted ID and with the title from the draft and the done value from the draft. Yeah, that return type has to be to-do because we don't fetch the database to-do entity. That's not necessary here. What we can do instead is call KDOM or these get to-do function here. So instead of that, call get to-do function and pass the inserted ID. That's also possible, but that's a little bit imperformant because all of that information that we need, that is still here in the draft and the inserted ID, so we can directly return a new to-do object. Okay, the next operation is the update to-do. Update to-do. Where we pass a ID and a draft. And then we call KTerm database.update. So the library, in my opinion, is really straightforward. So for each SQL operation, so insert, update, delete, there is a corresponding method. As I said, the only difference, when you want to return an ID, you have to call and generate key. And also the select operation is a little bit different. So in most of the cases, you call sequence of and specify the table name here. Okay, let's add the table name here as well. And that's really similar to that insert block here. So let's copy that. We want to update this to fields. And what's really important is that we only want single to-do, so we have to add a where condition. We do that with that where block, say that we only want to update the entries that have the ID, the same as the ID we passed in the method. Okay, this update operation returns how many rows we updated. And we say that the update operation is successful if the updated rows is greater than zero. Of course, this Boolean return value has to be added. I have done that with Alt Enter. And then we have to implement last operation, that's remove to do. The return value is also Boolean, so whether to-do operation was successful or not. Then KTerm database.delete with db to-do table also returns how many rows we have deleted. And here in this lambda block, we specify the condition, so what entries should be deleted. And we also go over the ID, use the ID. And we can say that the remove operation was successful when the deleted rows are at least one or greater than zero. Now go to MySQL to-do repository. And let's start with this get to-do operation. Here we can call database manager.get to do, pass the ID here. And now we have to map this database to do entity to a generic to do object. And there is a Kotlin method that comes with the Kotlin core package. And the name of the method is let. And in the let method, we create a new to-do object, specify the fields, and this let method returns the to-do object, so we can simply write return to-do. And this optional chaining operator only executes this block here if the returned object is not null. So if it's null, then yeah, null is returned to the executor of this method. Okay, then the addTodo method is really simple. We have simply call addTodo, pass a draft here, and return the result that is already a to-do object. Remove object is also really straightforward. Pass it a to, and the same goes for the update operation. Okay, so now we can start the application and test whether everything works. Okay, I have opened Postman again, that application we also used to test the in-memory repository. And now we use the same requests again and test whether our MySQL implementation works. So, send a request, we get the three to-do entries from the last episode. So that works. And when we only want the entry 3, that works as well. The next operation we want to test is addTodo. So go to body. That content is fine. That will be the to-do draft, which we want to insert. Click on send. And we get 200 OK. And here you see ID 4 was generated now by the database. And when we go to Navicut, refresh here, we see that a new entry was inserted into the to-do list. So let's update to-do 1, or let's update to-do 4. That was the one which we inserted now. So that is episode 6, I think. Click on send. Okay, 200, okay, let's look into the database. Refresh, okay, it's successfully updated. And let's test the delete route as well. We want to delete entries 1, 2, and 3. So let's start with entry 1, successfully deleted, okay. When we execute it again, we get 404. And then we want to delete number 2 and number 3. Refresh database, so 1, 2, 3 is away, 4 is the only remaining. Okay, that was all for this episode. Write in the comments what you think about this video. In the next episode, we will cover how to host a Ktor app in the cloud. And then in the coming episodes, we will talk about authentication and JSON Web Token. Stay tuned, have a nice day, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.